Hello guys, welcome to next video on Kotlin programming. So in this video we are going to discuss about Kotlin function with argument. So in last video we had discussed about function in Kotlin and what is the syntax of function. So in last video we had created one function called callMe function and we had called this callMe function in our main method. So in this video we are going to discuss how to create a function with argument. So let us delete this function. And I'm going to delete this too. So here let's write one function called getName. Between this parenthesis we have to pass our argument. So here we can have first name, which is of data type string, and here we can have last name, which is of data type string, and this will return a string value. So here let's write string which is equals to first name and last name. So here we had created one function called getName and we have two arguments, one is first name and last name. So both first name and last name has data type of string and which will return a string value, that is first name and last name. So let us try to call this getName function in our main method. So we are going to print this getName function. So let us use print statement and here let us write getName function. So here we have to pass two arguments, one is first name and last name. So when we try to run our program, here we get our name. So let me tell you one more time. So here we had created one getName function that takes two string argument. One is first name and another one is last name. And it returns a string value that is first name and the last name. So when we try to call this method in our main function, between this parenthesis we have to write two variables. One is first name and another one is last name. So when we try to run our program, this will call our getName function. So which has two arguments, one is first name and last name. So here in our console, we get our first name and last name. So let us print one more name. So I'm just going to copy this and I'm going to paste here. So instead of this John, we can write here Mark. And instead of this, we can write England. So when we try to run our program, in our console we get two names. So you can call this getName method as many times you want to call it. And these values are independent to each other. So this value will be stored in this first name and last name variable. And this function will return a string value and this will print your getName function. So this way we can pass argument in our function. So thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. Bye for now. See you next video.